And welcome back to Chicken Plays Real Video Games. Today, we're going to have a very special game. Guess what it is? It's Chicken's last year's game of the year. DuckTales Remastered. That's right, a remake of the old classic. You know what? Let's get to the nitty gritty. Okay, let me press this here. There we go. All right, I hope this is working. Please don't mess up on me. It's my first Xbox kit. Okay. All right. All right, let's do this. There we go. I'm gonna make sure something here. The options. I like the 8-bit music. I'm gonna take it out just for you. Get the new stuff. All right. Let's do this. Oh no! What's going on here?
Cuss me, Kiltz. Me money been alarm. Quick, Duckworth, get the limo.
I shall, get her in gear, sir.
Hurry, Duckworth, hurry!
The pedal is to the metal, Mr. McDuck.
Ugh, not the Beagle Boys again. If they think they can stand between Scrooge McDuck and his 3 cubic acres of cash, they've got another thing coming.
All right, let's get this going.
Boy.
Yeah, but you better watch out. The Beagle Boys messed with your security system.
Yeah, we take over the whole place.
Yeah, me money.
Hey, don't forget about me, Uncle Scrooge.
Oh, don't worry, lad. I'll save you.
Mom would be so proud. Now that's what I call a stomach ache.
You were hit on the head, you moronic marauder.
Thanks, Uncle Scrooge.
You're welcome, lad. But Huey, what are you doing here?
Well, we saw the Beagle Boys going into the money bin.
We?
Sure. Louie and Dewey are here, too. You better hurry, Uncle Scrooge, or you might be in trouble.
Over here. You gotta go after the secrets. Forget the tutorial. Everybody should know how to play this.
Take a look at the size of this diamond.
All right. I always mess this up. I finally got it.
I've never seen a gem like this before.
All right. Watch this. That's how you do it. If you don't get that treasure. You mess up if you don't get that new treasure right there. What?
Let me go, you beetle bum!
Not even for an afternoon snack. Big time in trouble, mate.
Get away from him, you gluttonous goon.
Sorry, Scroogey. Not a chance.
It's here for me to bully!
You saved me, Uncle Scrooge!
I did. Are you hot, lad?
Now, I'm fine. But I saw Louie heading up the stairs with about 1,000 Beagle Boys right behind him.
Stay here. I'll handle this.
There's another bully! A Beagle Boy! This is really messed up! You ain't the best security! You can't get these guys out of here! Come on, Uncle Scrooge!
Look at the size of this diamond!
Let's do something! Yeah! You gotta get the secret. Oh, I messed up. I gotta go back. I think. Yeah, I'm gonna try. There we go. That's right. Yippee! I'm so greedy.
Hold on, lad. I'll have you free in a jiffy.
Not so fast, McDuck. We're running things around here now.
Cuss me, kilt. One false move and I'm a roast duck.
Leave me, Uncle Scrooge. It's not worth it.
Nonsense, me boy. Oh, no.
You'll never beat us, Scrooge. When I get the gold, I'm gonna buy Ma a new hat.
Ow. What? Chico!
We almost got them all!
A fat lot of good that will do us if they make it to me vault.
I'll buy your mom a new hat, buy her house! What a cheap person! Steals like $100 million! He buys her a hat? For Macy's or something.
Step away from me, fortune, you crook.
Not this time, McDuck. Oh, you ain't getting the drop on this big old boy.
I'm smart. Why can't I just hit you with the stick? Okay.
Oh, dear. Do be careful or you'll scuff the floor.
Is that Alfred? I'm just kidding. Same back.
You're safe. The security is suspended, son. There you are, sir.
Oh, that's smart.
Come on.
Everything's ready, son.
That's right. You can get me? Oh no!
Everything's ready.
Yeah!
Curse you, McDuck! This ain't the last you'll see of me!
Yeah, good riddance to bad beagles, I say. Now, why in the world was he interested in this old painting?
Of course.
Surely there are more valuable. Well, pluck me pin feathers. It looks like some kind of secret code. Boys!
What did you find, Uncle Scrooge? Yeah, what is it?
I'm not sure, but I know how to find it out. I'll feed it into my supercomputer and use Gyro's new crypto analysis program. Then we'll know what the Beagle Boys were after. Stand back, lads.
Frickadoon! What is it, like a Scrooge?
It's a treasure map, lads. And no ordinary treasure by the look of things.
Only Uncle Scrooge would call any kind of treasure ordinary. Look! One of the treasures is in the middle of the Amazon! And there's another one in Transylvania! And one nearly 10 miles underground! Hey, wait a minute. Something's screwy. This last treasure can't be right. Yeah, there's no mountain on Earth that's that high. Well, according to the Junior Woodchuck's guidebook, to get there we'd have to take about 537 million steps straight up till we reach the moon. You mean the moon?
It looks that way, lads. Well, what are we waiting for? That treasure's not going to discover itself.
You know, before we start, we all know what I have to do. Come on. Come on, let's do it. Yay! Oh, this is just like the cartoon. Look at that. I'm not promoting any greed here. It's just fun to do that. I always wonder how he smells every time he gets in there. What he smells. Sorry, let's scratch my... There we go, my leg. You know, I love this. Alright, I'm sorry. Oh no, you must smell. I mean, you're going in a bunch of money. You gotta smell. Sorry, Uncle.
Get Launchpad on the horn. I'm headed to the Amazon jungle to find the scepter of the Incan King.
I can't even see that! Wait a minute! Hold up! Are you telling me I got crushed by a cloud? I thought I could go through a cloud. Video game logic, I'm telling you. It makes no sense! I'm sorry, I'm a little upset.
Thanks for the lift, Launchpad.
No problemo. Lift is one of my favorite principles of aerodynamics. Oh, say, you got your radio, Mr. McD?
Hey, of course I do.
Great! Then I'll be your eyes in the sky.
Oh, I'd be happy if you just keep your eyes on the sky for once. What an airhead.
Hey, I heard that.
Now then, ancient Incan legends claim the king's scepter was locked away in a giant temple of the clouds, and it should be dead ahead.
Gee, Mr. McD, I see a lot of clouds, but no temple.
You wouldn't, Launchpad. The legend says the temple was hidden away from all but King Manco Capquack himself. But there's bound to be a way to reveal it buried somewhere in this overgrown salad bowl. And I'm not leaving till I find it.
I'm so upset about that cloud. Come on, Mighty Joe Young! Come on! Come on, King Kong!
Launchpad, I found an ancient coin depicting a nightingale.
Edo! You haven't stumbled across a pizza joint down there, have you, Mr. McD? I'm getting kinda hungry up here.
I'm not even going to dignify that question with a response.
Oh, yeah. I'm going underground. Good enough for me.
Another coin, and this one has an inscription of an eagle.
That's right.
Maestro's robot.
I'm not really good at this part.
Aha! A coin bearing the image of the Queen's horse. Ha! It'll help us find the treasure for sure.
How can you tell, boss?
Never doubt the well-honed instincts of an experienced treasure hunter.
If you say so, Mr. McD.
Is that how you made your money? What are you worried about that? Is this guy like Donald Trump or something? Yes! We get that achievement! Yes! Yes! Ah! Can't believe it!
A coin showing the sun. Gads, I nearly tripped over it. This place is a mess. Where's Mrs. Beakley when you need her?
Mrs. Beakley! It's the maid from the cartoon.
Look at this. An ancient coin with the image of a scythe. It must represent a good harvest.
This is Launchpad, calling Mr. McD.
What is it, Launchpad?
I'm running a little low on fuel up here.
Well, where are the extra fuel canisters?
That's why I'm calling you, boss. I checked the glove compartment, but all I found was gloves.
Oh, you'd best find those fuel canisters, or the next thing you'll be flying is a model airplane.
Okay, okay. Last time I ask you for help.
Is that a promise?
I love Launchpad. You're one of my favorites. Like, go ahead.
Look at the size of this diamond.
Why did you design this stage? I have to go through here anyway. And we got coins.
Onward and upward. Now that's what I call a ruby.
Yes.
Up I go. Found another one, and it depicts the ruling might of a spear.
This is Launchpad, Mr. McD. Come in, Mr. McD.
No!
Launchpad, what was that?
Nothing, boss. I'm sure nobody was using that tree anyway. Except maybe them.
Be careful!
Look at this one. It shows a shield. You know, I bet those Incans could have minted a whole lot more coins if they hadn't tried to make each one unique.
Treasure! I don't know how everybody's doing today. Hope you're having a good day. Look at those bees. Those bees. Here we go. I got it!
Aha! This coin bears an image of the scales of justice. Just what I need to help me find the scepter.
You know, Mr. McGee, I had a thought.
Launchpad, why start now and spoil a perfect record?
That's a good question.
Well, I don't have all day. What was your thought?
Come to think of it, I forgot.
Launchpad, were you dropped on your head much as a child?
All the time. Why?
All the time! I love it!
Come in, Launchpad. I found something. There's a carving of Manco Capquack on this stone slab, and there's 8 circular notches around it.
Sounds great. Does it tell us how to find the treasure?
Well, I'm not sure what it tells us, but I'm certain it's an important clue. Bless me, bagpipes. These coins I found will fit perfectly into those notches.
Whoa, you must have come across an ancient Incan poker table, Mr. McDee. How about I come down there and you deal me in for a hand?
You come down here and I'll deal you a blow to the head. You're supposed to be keeping an eye out for trouble, remember?
Right. Trouble spotting it is.
That's funny.
Launchpad, what if the images on these coins symbolize the various tribes of Manco Capquack's empire? Maybe if I surround him with them.
How do you do that? Man, that was a good throw.
It's not working.
Hey, maybe you need to say the magic words. Or maybe not.
Will you look at that? The ancient city of Manco Capquack. And that beam of light. It must be pointing to the Temple of the Clouds. But how am I going to get across?
Up here, Mr. McDee.
Follow that beam of light.
Thank you, Launchpad. I appreciate it. I was in a greedy there. I won't do that again. No. Ah! I'm scared. I want that. I wonder who got that. I got that one from my tail.
Whoa! I did it. I found the legendary temple of Manco Capquack.
With a little help from your old pal, Launchpad McQuack.
Oh, of course, Launchpad. I couldn't have done it without you. Now just hold on, and with a little luck, that scepter will be mine in no time.
It's a priceless ruby.
You gotta know the secrets. They kept the same secrets from the old game. That's what I like about this. This is a real remaster. No offense to Sonic 2 for a moment, but that's not a remaster. That's an upgrade. This is how you remaster a game. From the ground up.
Speed.
I'm just out of station original game. Do something with it. Some of these developers are lazy. I gotta give Capcom this credit. This is hard work. This sprites. Beautiful.
It's a priceless ruby.
You all should get this game. It looks better when you play.
Oh, Mrs. Bigley, what are you doing here?
Really?
Someone has to make sure you get your daily nutrients, Mr. McDuck.
Oh, thank you kindly, dear.
All right, then. Goodbye, Mr. McDuck. I'll see you back in Duckburg.
Thank you, Mrs. Beakley. I appreciate it. I don't know how she got here, what vehicle she took to get here, but you know, I appreciate it.
Player one, player two.
All right, two missed. Watch out! Oh, look at those skills. Like a ninja.
Fire one,
baby. Well, I was firing two. Why you didn't say it that time? Kind of like it. Secret. Look at that, $1 million. What's going on now?
The size of Mrs. Beakley.
Ow, ow. The size of Mrs. Beakley. Oh, you're too much. Oh, no. Oh, no.
Onward and upward.
That's what I get for dissing Mrs. Beakley.
Run.
You better do good this time. Come on, Mrs. Beakley. Ooh, it was fun.
Please.
Here we go again. Good. Stop me now!
Stop my goal!
Love it! Mrs. Beakley! Oh, wow! You're something else, Uncle Scrooge! Nice skills! Look at that move!
How dare you!
Bro! What are you doing there? You see people with spears? Where'd it come from?
The size of this diamond!
Another secret! I'm gonna try to get this achievement! Bear with me!
There it is, the king's scepter. Well, oh, this was easier to find than a penny in a parking lot.
What? Whoa!
Catch me, kilts. What was that?
Boss fight! You like that? You gotta hit him 9 times! Pretty scary. Don't try this at home, kids. Maybe the video game. At that time. Got it! cave in.
Hurry, Mr. McTee. This place has fallen to pieces.
No, I'm not leaving without that scepter. Get us out of here, Launchpad.
Nice.
I cannot believe we came all this way for nothing.
Happens.
What's the meaning of this?
Outsider, our prophecies have long foretold that our ancient city would one day be returned to us. For hundreds of years we have waited, and at last that day has come.
You mean you're not mad at me?
Mad? Quite the contrary, Feathered One. Is there anything we can do to repay you?
Well, now that you mention it, I did come here looking for an ancient scepter. I didn't suppose...
Does it look like this? It fell from the temple.
Oh, they're climbing for nothing. Hey, Mr. McDee?
Bless me bagpipes, the scepter of the Incan King!
It is yours. Take it and go in peace.
Thank you! I appreciate it!
After all, it was just the old king's back scratcher.
Someone's garbage is someone else's treasure. We learned a lesson. Value is in the eye of the beholder. That's a good lesson.
The scepter of the Incan King. I tell you, boys, there's something special about this treasure.
Really, Uncle Scrooge? Yeah, it just looks like an old back scratcher to us.
You boys need to learn some respect for the finer things in life. Now, if you're done having fun at your old uncle's expense, help me decide where we should go next.
I'm sorry, the finer things in life? What do you mean, money? I don't think so, Uncle Scrooge. You gotta learn that lesson later in this game.
Pack your bags, boys. We're off to Transylvania, and we're no coming back without the coin of the Lost Realm.
Man! Don't get so special about a ruby on back scratcher. It's not birdseed. No? Look at that. What is that? Why is it running on top of me? What? Get off!
This is it, kids. Draculesti Manor, home of the legendary Drake von Vladstone, heir to the coin of the Lost Realm.
Boy, it's kind of creepy out here, isn't it? Uncle Scrooge, we're not going to break into this guy's house, are we?
Of course not, Louie. This castle has been abandoned for centuries.
Hey, look at this. The Junior Woodchuck Guidebook says Drake von Vladstone was best known by his nickname, Count Dracula Duck. Is there really a monster in there, Uncle Scrooge? Don't be silly, Webby. Yeah, there's no such thing as Dracula. Right! He is right, isn't he, Uncle Scrooge?
Of course he is, Louie. Vampires, banshees, and mischievous spirits are just a lot of superstitious hocus-pocus.
Oh!
But you better stick close to me, just in case.
I'm scared. Little scared.
Now you boys stay put and keep an eye on Wee Webbergale. I'll be back with the treasure in no time.
Aw, nuts. We want to come with you, Uncle Scrooge.
Yeah.
Don't worry. I'll be back with the coin before you can say E pluribus unum.
What?
E pluribus unum? Yeah, I'm not sure that's as fast as you think it is. Besides, why should we have to stay here just because Webby's a big chicken?
What?
Yeah. We're not afraid of...
What's
hiding out there, are we? You boys are so mean. I'll show you who's not afraid of the dark. Wait, Webby!
No!
Oh, no!
Huey, Dewey, Louie!
Will they be all right, Uncle Scrooge?
Of course. Everything will be fine, my darling. Wait here, and I'll be back with the lads lickety-split.
That's what you get for saying that she's a big chicken! I'm a big chicken!
I'm like a money magnet.
Careful here. If you hit the rocks before you get that treasure, you won't be able to get it. Maybe. Okay, I'm trying to cheat. I just don't want Mrs. Binkley to feed me too much.
Mrs. Binkley, is that you?
It most certainly is. Why, just look at all these cobwebs. This place could use a woman's touch.
What?
Marvelous job, as usual, Mrs. Beakley.
It's nice to see you, but I can take care of myself very well, thank you.
I see.
Perseverance pays off again.
So then I think she took the treasure. Maybe. Suspicious, Mrs. Beakley.
Ow!
Mr. Ghost? Oh no! Hope you don't eat me! Wait a minute!
Yo! I'm out of here!
Beagle
hey,
Boy!
That wasn't a ghost at all! It was a Beagle Boy in disguise!
Trying to beat me to my treasure, no doubt. But it'll take more than just an old bedsheet and flower dust to frighten off Scrooge McDuck.
That's right.
You're talking Scrooge, that Beagle Boy dropped something. It's an old piece of paper.
Twist
what?
Me, Captain. It's an ancient rune.
You mean like a magic spell?
Aye, lad. At least part of one.
Gee, I wonder who tore it into pieces.
We'll worry about that later. Right now, I want you to head to the front door and wait for me. I'll be back once I've found the treasure. Off you go, lad.
So irresponsible to leave something on the floor like that. What a chance of that happening again.
I really lost my hat on that one.
For real? Duck your head! Jump!
Ooh!
You may know how good that move was. I need it again.
Ooh! Is there no end to this madness? I really lost my hat on that one.
Yes!
Ooh!
You saw that! Those are called skills.
Hat on that one.
Yeah. Skills!
He'll think twice before scrapping with Scrooge McDuck.
Speaking of scraps, he dropped this, Uncle Scrooge.
Are you kidding me?
Ah, it looks like another piece of that torn-up sorcery.
Say what?
A magic spell. And it's nearly complete. Just one piece left to find. If only I knew where to start looking.
Well, that Bungle Boy did say this house has an illusion wall. Do you think he meant...
Of course, a secret passage. Oh, no wonder I've been having so much trouble finding anything around here. Good lad. Now, off you go. I need you to wait at the entrance with the others.
You gotta be kidding me! This guy drops paper too? Don't send these guys to the post office!
Diamond!
Don't send them to the post office! Trust me, you'll lose your mail in 5 minutes! How responsible can you be? You smell like me? Oh yeah. The last one! I know where it is! The last one! I got hit in the face!
Say tough without your army helmet, eh?
Wait till the gang in Sing Sing finds out you were knocked flat by an old guy in his cave.
thank you, lad.
Yeah? Well, you better be careful where you go poking around, McDuck, or you's gonna have much bigger problems than me. So long.
Now, what do you suppose he meant by that? Ach, it doesn't matter. Quick, lad, see if there's a scrap of paper lying about.
You mean like this one, Uncle Scrooge?
Exactly. This is the last piece of the riddle.
What to do?
That's what I'm about to find out. Quick, lad, go meet Webby and the others at the entrance. And all of you, stay put.
He made fun of Scrooge.
Seen a gem like this before. Once an adventurer, always an adventurer.
There's a trick to that.
What I call a ruby.
So some people just destroy those boxes before getting up there. You have to keep them alive.
This part of the spell matches the inscriptions on this mirror. Luck of the ducks! I solved the riddle!
What riddle, Uncle Scrooge?
Boys, I thought I told you to stay with Webby.
They did stay with me, Uncle Scrooge. I'm right here. Oh, what a pretty mirror.
Aye, lass. And if I'm right, using this spell will reveal the foul perpetrator behind all these shenanigans.
Tickling her!
Magic at the spell. Ach, I should have known you'd be behind this.
Oh, Scroogey, my old friend. You wouldn't believe how much fun it is watching you run around making a fool of yourself.
What?
Oh, you really don't think you need ancient sorcery to find Coin of Lost Realm, do you? No, I had Beetle Boy's hide paper scraps to throw you off trail.
Why, you sneaky, conniving...
Please, save compliments for garden party.
What garden party?
The one I will throw in celebration when I get home with Lost Coin. So long, fools!
Gee, she isn't very nice.
No.
You said it, Webby.
All right, you kids stay here. I'm going to track down that witch and give her a piece of my mind.
Open the door! There's a problem! No song? Any glitch? I messed up there.
Yippee!
Even the music is scared.
Why must you always meddle? That coin is mine!
Oh, I messed up! Oh. The recovery! I don't like hitting my fellow birds, but I have no choice.
This will have to...
You evil bird! Disgrace to my species! Wait! Nice shot! cheese. I don't feel sorry for this. I'm not gonna get it.
You are full, Lord. How do you like this?
A genius. You're no competition for me! I did it!
Lassie's inferior mirror and beam spells. It's the last time I shop for spell ingredients at discount store.
What? What store
you
is
haven't
that?
Seen Last of Magic of the Spell. You may have Coin of Lost Realm, but your number one dime will soon be mine.
Yeah, that's Scrooge!
She should be a rapper. She should be mine. That's what you get for making me little mad. Doing that to me.
Do you think Magica will keep out of our way now, Uncle Scrooge?
It's hard to say, lad. Folks like her have a way of popping up at the most inconvenient moments.
Well, when it comes to Magica, there's no such thing as a convenient moment.
Too true, Louie. Now then, where to next, lads? Pack my parka, Duckworth. We're headed for the Himalayas to hunt for the lost crown of Genghis Khan.
Shall I forward your call, sir?
Gee, can I come, Uncle Scrooge?
No!
I want to see the pretty Himalayan marmots.
So, no, not this time, Libby, darling. I need you here looking after the boys. Otherwise, who knows what kind of trouble they might get into.
That's right.
Oh, that's very smart. Uncle Scrooge!
Indulge me, lads. The last thing this expedition needs is a wee lass about. Ugh, I'm going to have enough trouble looking after the launch pad.
That's true. We're halfway there, friends. This should be interesting.
Launch pad. I told you to land in the center of the mountain range, not in the center of a mountain.
Gee, Mr. McDee, I thought that crash was rock solid.
The only rocks around here are the ones inside your head. Ugh, we're nowhere near Shadow Pass and the Lost Crown. Now fix this wreck so we can get airborne and step on it, lad. I'm paying you by the hour, and I'll nae having you billing me for overtime.
No problem, boss. As long as I have this fuel regulator, we're as good as... Whoopsie-daisy. Oops. My mom always said I was a Butterfingers.
Oh, no. Please tell me you've got another one of those.
Sure I do. But it's back in Duckburg.
Launchpad!
Don't worry, Mr. McDee. I'll climb down and get it.
You'll do no such thing. I'll get it. You stay here and try not to cause any more damage.
Okay, you're the boss.
Okay, let's play. It's all these things. This is the challenge. See? Can't pull a stick in the snow!
touch that. I need it to fix my plane. Stop!
Top of Bunny Rabbit Tuesday!
It's too late. Those bunny bandits have torn it apart. I've got to find those pieces fast.
What are we doing at? What, I haven't been fed or something? Another heart! I might get the achievement! You wanna see a lot! You have to use them out! I should have gotten that. I think he has it. Yes!
Morning and glory! Now to find the other two pieces.
Where's the other one? I'm gonna do it as fast as I can! I got it!
It's the second piece of the fuel regulator. One more piece to find and we can get out of this overgrown icebox.
Hey, watch it! Oh, no you don't.
Yes! Now we're gonna get the last piece and get out of here. Oh, wait a minute!
That's me, kilts! It's Bubba Duck! Looks like the poor little pea brain got caught in a deep freeze.
Welcome back, Bubba! Hey, Bam Bam, a doctor!
Oh, what happened? Scrooge! Ooga Ooga! Scrooge saved Bubba!
Scrooge?
There, little fella. Uncle Scrooge is here to help.
Scrooge saved Bubba! Scrooge saved Bubba! Scrooge saved Bubba! Bubba help Scrooge! Bubba help Scrooge forever!
You know, I could use a bit of help smashing away this giant icebox. What do you say, Bubba?
Ooga, ooga!
In that case, follow me, lad!
Let's do it!
Ooga, ooga!
What a beauty!
Nice! Ooga, ooga. Come on, crash the bunny rat! Looks like he's not gonna go for it. I'll do it myself. You gotta be kidding me! I needed that! Not too much, Bubba. Look at this! What does that mean?
Treasure.
I had no choice.
This is the end of the line, Bubba. It's time for you to head to the surface.
Bubba home with Scrooge?
Aye. Launch pad is waiting to take you home to Duckburg. On your way now.
That's so nice of Uncle Scrooge. That's really nice. Thank you.
luck of the ducks. The last one.
Thank
now to get this fuel regulator back to launch pad.
That's what I call a ruby.
There you go, Launchpad. Good as new. Now get this bucket of bolts back in the sky.
Just a tick, Mr. McD. This oughta do it.
What?
Now there's your problem.
Webbergail, what in the world are you doing here?
I wanted to see the pretty crown, Uncle Scrooge.
Oh, great. Now I've got to babysit you and Launchpad.
We're ready for liftoff, Mr. McD.
And not a moment too soon. Strap in tight, Webby dear.
Off we go. Nothing but blue skies ahead. Clear as a bell. Not a cloud in sight.
Launchpad, knock off that infernal chatter.
Gee whiz, I was only trying to lighten the mood.
If anything, we need to lighten the plane. Feels like she's lost maneuverability with all the, unexpected cargo we seem to have picked up.
No worries, Mr. McD. I've got the coordinates for Shadow Pass locked in. We'll be there lickety-split.
More like lickety-splat.
Glomgold.
Nice to see you, McDuck. Especially since you've led me right to the treasure. To whom do I owe my thanks? Your idiotic pilot? Or did you play it safe and let those two wee ones fly the plane?
You dirty cheat. Only you could sink so low.
And at 15,000 feet, no less.
Complain all you like. The lost crown of Genghis Khan will look right at home on my feathered noggin. Wouldn't you say, Scroogey?
That's what you think. You'll never beat us to Shadow Pass.
So, the crown is in Shadow Pass, eh? Thanks for telling me.
Boy.
Launch pad.
Look at that big mouth.
Here comes a 10 megaton finder's feet.
Hey, come on,
boys. One old duck with a cane shouldn't be any trouble to take down.
Yeah, I don't know how you got in that engine, Webbergail.
Ouch.
Makes no sense.
Turn a profit on this, McDuck.
Make a profit on you.
Off, hurry, you fools! He's catching up!
I did it!
You haven't seen the last of me, McDuck!
Oh boy, I gotta see you again?
Take that, you big old meanie! We sure showed him that cheaters never cheat and winners never win, didn't we?
Try it the other way around and I couldn't agree more, Webby. Pickle me, pin feathers, there it is. Shadow Pass directly ahead. Take us down, Launchpad. Slow and steady this time.
No problemo, Mr. McD.
We're close to that treasure now. I can almost smell it.
wasn't me.
Then what was it?
That definitely wasn't me.
Whatever it is, it won't last long if it tries to get between me and the Lost Crown.
Uncle Scrooge, don't go!
Don't worry, lassie. Whatever's in that cave is no match for your Uncle Scrooge. I earn my fortune by being smarter than the smarties and tougher than the toughies. If anything's in there, it'd better step aside.
But I'm scared.
Stay with Launchpad. He'll take good care of you.
Stay with Launchpad? Gee, now I'm extra scared.
Well, I don't know how Launchpad feels about those words. Poor Launchpad. Not that greedy. No! Come on! Okay, you got me that time. Super Mario?
This monster tried to pummel me. Why, I nearly cashed my last check.
That's right.
Oh, I know, ma'am. But Uncle Scrooge is really nice once you get to know him.
Webby, you understand this creature?
Of course, Uncle Scrooge. It's all in a Junior Woodchuck guidebook.
What's she saying now?
She says she's sorry if she hurt you. She's just upset because she stepped on a thorn. I can't get it out.
A thorn? You don't suppose... Here's your thorn, Webbigail. The lost crown of Genghis Khan.
The pretty crown. You found it.
Why is it so hurty?
The poor creature was standing on it. Willie,
don't cry.
I cannot thank you enough. I hope you can find it in your heart to forgive me. Without your help, we never would have found the treasure. Oh, and thanks to you, too. ma'am?
I think she likes you, Uncle Scrooge.
Yeah, that's odd. Usually it's me the ladies go gaga for.
Well, let's get home before she grows any fonder of me.
I don't know if to disagree with Abigail. I don't know, punching a wall and throwing a bunch of ice cubes at you? I don't know if it was a mistake or not. I support Uncle Scrooge. You defended yourself from a big bully. Step on the crowd, you ask him to take him out. I get it.
The lost crown of Genghis Khan is mine, lads. All it took was a bit of tenacity and perseverance.
And a little kindness and patience. Right, Uncle Scrooge?
Right you are, Webby darling. Now, where's Bubba run off to?
Yeah, where is he? He was here a minute ago.
Why don't you answer Bubba?
He's over there having a tea party with Webby's toys.
No, Bubba Smash!
Uh-oh, Webby. Sounds like Bubba's not getting along so good with your Quacky Patch dolls.
You keep away from my dolls, mister!
Remember, kindness and patience, Webbygale. Set a good example for the lad. Well then, what treasure shall we look for next?
The last two! Almost there!
Find Gyro. Our next stop's Africa, at the center of the Earth.
What treasure do you think you'll find there, Uncle Scrooge?
Only the largest gem known to history. The giant diamond of the inner earth.
Should be interesting. The very overlooked stage. Let's go to the African mines. Good thing it was over my head. Oh, there we go. What are you doing? Get off of me. I don't know what you are. Are you a slug, snail?
Hi, lads. This is the place. I can feel all those diamonds singing to me. And it's a right pretty song, too. Gyro, I thought you said this winch was brand new.
It was. It's an unbreakable diamond tether, Mr. McDuck. I made it myself.
So long as you didn't use any of my diamonds to do the job. What's all this hullabaloo? Your lunch break isn't for 2 hours yet.
We heard voices down there, Mr. McDuck. Strange, ghostly voices.
Nonsense. There aren't any voices down there.
Whatever you say, Mr. McDuck. But your mine is haunted. You finish digging it.
Ugh, you want anything done, you've got to do it yourself. And believe me, if I hear voices down there, I'll give them a good talking to. Now, you stay here, boys. I'm going to get to the bottom of this.
The rock bottom, Mr. McDuck. This mine shaft goes down for miles.
There's time. I had a nutrition there for me. Been an hour already.
Class two. It's a diamond the size of Mrs. Beakley.
Go again, Mrs. Beakley. Remember last time? And look what happened! That's what you get. You keep saying that.
This old lid won't budge, Uncle Scrooge. Looks like the key's missing. You don't think the ghost ran off with it, do you?
Look, if I hear one more word about this mine being haunted, I'll start haunting it myself.
Hey, you found the key. Did the ghosts have it?
Oh, I'm telling you kids for the last time. There are no ghosts in this mine.
I don't know about that, Uncle Scrooge. Something must have cut the tether line and broke the winch and scared away those workers.
I'll tell you what scared them away. Overactive imaginations. I'm not about to let a bunch of silly superstitions stand between me and the giant diamond of the inner earth. Mm-hmm. Now, man the controls and lower away, lads!
I don't know. We just went to Transylvania. We saw a bunch of ghosts here. Are you still not convinced? No! That achievement is gonna happen.
Mrs. Beakley, what are you doing here?
Someone has to make sure you get your daily nutrients, Mr. McDuck.
You're always as good as you want, my dear.
Give her away! No man will go that far. Skill. So many secrets!
Oh, no, you don't.
Check this out. I messed up a bit.
I have one.
Look at that luster.
See?
It's mine.
Now that's what I call a ruby.
Money for me, money bin.
That's how you do it. Uh-oh. I'm scared. Oh, no!
Gangway,
keep going. Through. Doesn't matter. Money or death. You don't want your life. Keep going. No, you gotta be kidding me. You gotta be kidding me. Urgh.
being foolish.
Maybe by being greedy. You're not paying your boys enough money. I'm sorry, I was just shooting.
Do you suppose those are?
Out of the way!
What? These kids.
Oh, my aching tail feathers.
Boys, did I not tell you to stay with Gyro?
Well, we,
I'm disappointed in you lads. It's dangerous down here.
We just wanted to help Uncle Scrooge. Yeah.
Hush, lads. Did you hear that?
Wackaroonie! Those must be the voices that miner was talking about.
You boys go back the way you came. This is no place for children.
Yes, Uncle Scrooge.
Okay. Just gotta be careful. More dangerous than ones in Mario. Back. Here we go!
You! What's the meaning of all this racket?
Out of the way, stranger. As the king of the Terraformians, I forbid anyone to interfere with the Great Games.
Great Games?
Stand back! You'll interfere with the Rowl. Ooh. Strange creature, you are disqualified.
What?
You're disqualified for unsportsmanlike conduct and roll and crash interference.
What's this guy?
I own this mine, and I won't be bossed around by an overblown fuzzball. Step aside, I've got work to do.
Oh, so you're the one causing all the ruckus up above. Well, I have heard enough.
I did it! Come on, I stole this! Come on! That's nauseous! Making up rules by disqualifying me! How do you like that?
Under your assault no longer, stranger. What is it you wish from us?
Well, for starters, stop these infernal games. You're causing earthquakes, scaring off my workers, and ruining my equipment. It's nigh impossible to mine for diamonds.
Diamonds?
Aye, diamonds. Like this one, though the particular one I'm after is a fair bit bigger.
Oh, you refer to garbage rocks. We have no use for garbage rocks. They're hard and sharp, and you can't roll on them at all.
You don't say. tell you what, I'll do you a favor and haul away your garbage rocks free of charge. Just keep the earthquakes to a minimum, all right?
Agreed. I am proud to announce that the Terraformians hereby welcome your garbage rock mining operation. Here, you can start by getting rid of this one.
Bless me, bagpipes. The giant diamond of the inner earth.
I still don't like this guy's personality. Alright, I'm back. I figure I'd turn the light while that happens. What do I do here?
Gee, okay. Uncle Scrooge, you mean there weren't any ghosts down there after all?
That's right, Louie. It's as I told you, boys. There's a rational explanation for everything.
Yeah, a whole kingdom of underground creatures who cause earthquakes as part of a game is a completely rational explanation.
Never mind, boys. The point is, we made it back with a giant diamond of the inner earth. And gained an entire diamond mine in the process. Now, where to next, lads? It's a long way to the moon, lads. But the green cheese of longevity will make it worth the trip. Up, up, and away!
It's the last stage. Are you ready? Are you ready for this? There's no point. They're just coming on top of me.
Gosh, Mr. McDuck. I've never been to the moon before.
Well, when it comes to space cadets, Fenton, you're a natural. Now, Gyro, why in blazes are we chewing this awful blue muck?
Why, that's Oxy-Chew, Mr. McDuck. It's my latest invention, oxygen-flavored taffy. Five good chews and you can breathe on the lunar surface without a spacesuit. Oh, and it tastes great, too.
That, Gyro, is a matter of opinion. Now, which way to the green cheese?
What do you mean? Isn't it all around us?
Yeah? How do you figure?
Everybody knows the whole moon's made of green cheese. Well, that's what my dear mama said.
And did it take a feather brain like you to believe her? Ugh, sometimes I don't know what I'm gonna... Wait, what's that?
Look, here's someone who can give us directions. Hello?
Ah.
Mr. McDuck! Help!
Oh, no!
We've got to save him!
Do we really?
We do if you want to find that treasure of yours, Mr. McDuck. Fenton was carrying the Gizmo Duck suit. That's the only thing we've got powerful enough to break into the moon vault.
All right, fine. Stay here and guard the supplies while I look for that bumbling bookkeeper.
Thank you. It was one of my favorite stages. Hopefully I'll find out Yasha's enemy. Let's do this.
This diamond.
I don't get the point of that power up. I mean, that's like 2 seconds.
Oh, no, you don't. Why, that looks like the same spaceship that took off with Fenton. Well, I guess this means I'm invited on board.
Nice! Alright!
Blast me, bagpipes! A piece of Gizmo Duck suit! Oh, if only I had a way to open this door.
I'm gonna do it right now! Come on, we sing along! Oh, wait a minute. Here goes Fenton!
Fenton, get down from there! And stop embarrassing yourself.
Mr. McDuck! Thank goodness you're here! I think those aliens wanted to suck out my brain and make an army of Fenton clones.
Bah, they'd soon learn that one of you is one too many. Now, help me find a security override so we can get to your Gizmo Duck suit.
You mean this?
Security system disengaged.
Fenton, you're a genius!
Gee, Mr. McDuck, do you mean it? Oops.
Warning. Damage report. Artificial gravity system is offline.
Fenton, you're a nincompoop. You broke the gravity controls.
Not to worry. I'll have it fixed in a jiffy. I got a level 3 certificate of technology from Happy Ducky University, you know.
Oh, no you don't. You'll probably slam into the self-destruct button, too. I'll get us out of this.
Oh wow, this is cool!
Gravity system restored. All systems normal.
Nice work, Mr. McDuck! Now, let's go get my Gizmo Duck suit!
Not so fast, Dunderhead. You go wait with Gyro. I'll find the Gizmo Duck suit myself.
I'm gonna find the pieces! We're gonna get Gizmo and Duck together. I need to find a place. Sorry, I gotta check again.
I found Gizmo Duck's armored suit. It's a good thing Gyro rigged up this hyperspace pocket for me to carry things around in. Now, only two more parts to find, and we can break into that moon vault.
Go there in a bit. Just trying to get that part.
Waka waka, it's a treasure. Mrs. Bigley, now where did you come from?
Why, from home, of course. I had to be sure you were all right in this filthy place.
You're always as good as you were, my dear.
Oh, finally got the chat thing working. Anybody wants to say anything? Find the last one.
I wondered what Gyro was thinking when he designed this thing. Who fights crime with a unicycle? Now, just one more part to find, and I can get off this flying monstrosity. Ugh, my arms are getting tired.
Mine's too, but don't worry, you're gonna do it. My feathers. At least they counted. I'm so stupid. It's alright, I have no time. Let's get it over with. There we go.
That's Gizmo Duck's helmet. Oh, if I didn't know better, I'd swear Fenton actually gets smarter when he wears this thing. Maybe I'm a wee bit too hard on the lad. Now that I've got all three parts, I can head back to Fenton and Gyro. I hope it's not too late.
That was stupid of me! They done better.
No point in hanging around here.
I did it! Come on! Alright!
We're in luck. I managed to find Gizmo Duck suit.
Oh boy! Now we could blast into the treasure vault!
Just a moment, Fenton. Gyro, I think I left my favorite $2 bill under the back seat. Would you mind getting it for me?
What?
Sure thing, Mr. McDuck.
What type of bill is that?
Gee, boss! Why'd you send Gyro back onto the ship?
So he doesn't find out you're Gizmo Duck when you put on that suit, you dunderhead.
But there are only three of us here, sir. Won't he figure it out anyway when Gizmo Duck appears and I've mysteriously vanished?
I wouldn't worry about that. Gyro may be a brilliant inventor, but his deductive reasoning skills are about as good as yours.
Oh, hey!
Why don't you just get on with it? Say your secret code word and activate that confounded contraption.
Code word? Gee, I can't remember it. Oh, blather and blatherskite, I'm useless. I mean, I'm useful to the extreme. Point me toward the offending blockade so that I might deal justice upon it.
Cut the dramatics, would you, and follow me.
Mr. McDuck? Fenton? Gizmo Duck? They're gone. And all I could find was this $2 million bill. Oh, well, back under the seat it goes.
What? Guess he was right. Yay! I love Gizmo Duck. Blabber and Blabberskite! These robots!
This is the place. Gyro's calculation said the green cheese of longevity lies just beyond this door.
Step aside, citizen, whilst I blast the door asunder!
How was that, Mr. Mc... I mean, well, the path is clear, good sir!
Good work, Gizmoduck. Now... Ah! Flint-Hat Glumgold! What are you doing here, you pernicious pilferer?
Why, same as you, Scroogey. Trying to corner a new segment of the dairy market.
Why, you... How did you find out about the green cheese?
Wouldn't you like to know? But thanks for saving me the trouble of blasting through that door on my own.
I'll stop him, Mr. McDuck! Halt, evildoer!
No, Gizmoduck. I need you to help me deal with the... Beagle Boys. Bah!
Can't believe it. You gotta watch it. If you never watched DuckTales, watch the one with Gizmo Duck. You'll like it. Very good storyline. Don't make cartoons like this anymore. Ah! Appears after I destroyed it. I could go back, but I don't feel like it. It's a secret!
1 billion 1, 1 billion 2.
I got achievement! I did it! Bless me, bagpipes! I did it! Haha, you're so alive! That made me very happy!
I made it here first. No, not the cheese. Anything but that.
What'd you expect? It's a rut.
Great Scott. I thought that stuff was supposed to be an anti-aging culture, not an instant growth fungus.
No. Watch the skills. So old school!
It's gaining interest. I mean, speed!
Go skill! Come on, one more time! Yay!
Look, giant moon rat or no giant moon rat, nothing's gonna keep this duck from that green cheese and all the green it's gonna make me.
I did it. Is that the end? Or is it not? You're the skeptics. Keep it all.
We did it, boys. All five treasures are mine.
Yay!
Boys?
Wait a minute.
Sorry, MacDuck, but your meddlesome nephews are a wee bit tied up at the moment.
Flintheart Glumgold, you put the Beagle Boys up to this.
Guilty as charged, Scroogey. I've been the world's second richest duck long enough, but these treasures will soon change that.
Oh, tell your goons to release my boys.
Not till you fork over that last treasure.
Don't do it, Uncle Scrooge. Don't do it.
The way I see it, MacDuck, you're not in much to argue.
Yeah, aye. You drive a hard bargain, Glumgold. Take it, you filthy cheat.
Flintheart Glumgold, the richest duck in the world. How does it feel to be number two, Scroogey?
What?
Magicka dispel!
It's so rude of me to drop in unannounced.
What are you doing here, Magicka? Quick, somebody sound the alarm! Duckworth, Mrs. Beagley, call the Pentagon! Sell me stock and bonds!
Not so fast, fools!
Rack-a-rooty, Uncle Scrooge! I can't move!
Me neither. Now I know how a statue feels.
Greedy old fools. These treasures are far more valuable than money.
And just what do you mean by that?
You find secrets hidden inside old painting, yes? Painting of Drake von Gladstone, also known as Count Dracula Duck. These treasures are part of spells to summon him.
Bah, what rubbish.
You will see. With power of Dracula Duck under my command, I will rule the world. Unless, you'd rather surrender number one dime, Scrooge. Dime is much gentler way to conquer world. Will save me great deal of trouble. Also, less risk of accidental Dracula bite.
The first dime I ever made? Never.
Then I will take precious nephews instead. You will bring me dime quickly enough after that.
Hey, Dimsies are hostages. Find your own.
Quiet, Piggle Boys.
What? That's not nice.
Now I take leave. Bring number one dime to my home on Mount Vesuvius in 24 hours, or little nephews will become Snackula for Dracula. Yeah!
What the rap in here? Okay.
Oh, sometimes I still get carried away.
That lousy, no good so and so. I stole those treasures. Fair and square.
This is no time for bellyaching, Glumgold. I've got to save those boys.
Ha! Forget it. That she-devil's long gone. You can't catch her now.
Maybe you're right, Flinty. That leaves me no choice. How about a deal? You help me get the boys back, and you can keep the five treasures.
Ha! Without your dime, I'll become the richest duck in the world, and you'll be nothing but a shriveled up old has-been.
That dime's not worth 10 cents next to the safety of my boys. Do we have an agreement?
Are you joshing? It's a deal. You know what I think, MacDuck?
I think you've gone soft. You've let those pesky rugrats become a business liability. And I'm gonna be the richer for it.
Dog, go suck your head.
See, that's the lesson. Nothing's more valuable than family. I'm proud of Scrooge. He finally woken up from his greediness. There's a big moral here. Two rich people fighting to be the richest? Not the poor people.
Now remember our deal, Flinty. Help me rescue the lads, and the treasure is yours.
You keep up your end, and I'll keep up mine.
Best song in the game! Soundtrack's off the hook! The power!
There's got to be a way through.
Put your back into
how
it, MacDuck!
Like hurry up, Grumgold! Time is money! I didn't get
it could
to
be dangerous,
MacDuck!
You go first!
I didn't get rich by being foolish.
What?
I'm growing old, just not as old as you.
I'm going as fast as I can.
Shut this guy up! Watch out for the rocks!
This is getting interesting. I mean, speed!
Come on, Uncle Scrooge, we can do it! The power of love!
Like you asked. Quit complaining.
I've still got it.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh!
to move on, MacDuck!
Age before beauty, Clinty.
Ha ha! I like that!
Just what I had in mind.
I was game of the year!
Washed up has-beens first, MacDuck.
It took you long enough to catch up. What's the matter? Gold bricks in your caboose?
Oh, shut your beak. You're not getting any younger yourself, you old windbag.
Hush! Magicka may not know we're here yet. We don't want to lose the element of surprise.
So... you have decided to deliver Dime after all.
Release my nephews, you evil enchantress.
Oh, not until you show me number one Dime.
Here it is. Now let the boys...
What?
It's been great doing business with you, Scroogey.
What?
You've been in cahoots from the beginning.
No, even before beginning. Do you remember who sold your painting in first place? T'was me in disguise, you fool.
Why, you... no wonder it was such a bargain.
$5 painting for you saved expensive treasure hunting expedition for me. And now, at long last, I am ready to use treasures to complete spells.
Enough with the smoke and mirrors routine. You've got my dime. Now release the lads.
Oh, boo-hoo. No time for buyer's remorse from old has-been. Better to stick with master plan. Is much more exciting. I now summon Dracula Duck.
What can I call him, Duckula?
Behold! Dracula Duck. I, Magicka the Spell, have summoned you to do my bidding. You must obey my will and mine alone. And my will is that you destroy this meddling old fool.
I can't believe I got betrayed!
Didn't get to be number one, my back and
do.
No, shit!
I command you. Breath is worse than his bite.
Oh no, I hate this one! A little tricky. Castlevania! This is gonna be a spoof on Konami!
Don't give up! You power back!
that pretty good. Yes. You can't see me.
How dare you? Bang, tooth fool. Don't let Scrooge beat you.
Oh, no! So big. Don't try to eat me. You can't do it. Please don't try to eat me. I got this.
Stop meddling. A guy like Mav.
Is this guy gonna go down? Like Castlevania. I did it.
Oh, boys, I'm so glad you're all right.
We knew you'd save us, Uncle
Scrooge. We knew you would.
We sure did.
Down that hall, lads. Launch pad will be waiting to take you to safety.
What about you, Uncle Scrooge?
Yeah, the whole place is falling apart.
Magic and Glumgold still have my number one dime, and I'm not leaving without it. You boys get going.
So greedy!
Good luck, Uncle Scrooge!
Good luck, Uncle Scrooge!
Now, give me dime!
Not till you give me those treasures. I want to be filthy, stinking rich.
You already are filthy, stinking rich.
But not as rich as that Chiseler McDuck. Where's the treasure?
That's what
no
you get!
Horseplay. I need that dime.
Oh, no, you don't, Missy!
Let go, you fool!
Not till I get that treasure!
There it is! This is it! This is pretty hard! Some people have problems with this! I'm gonna show them how to do it! I'm sure I'll probably die a couple of times! You stupid of me! I was done! Just jump! I don't think I'm gonna make it! I'm gonna try again!
Number one dime is mine!
No, it isn't! No! No! A fool makes a mistake twice. I did it! I got it!
Nice try, Magicka, but I'll be taking my dime with me back to Duckburg. Have a lovely time together.
It's time to get out of here. The tricky part! See? This is how you do it! I know some people can't do this, but I can do it! Watch this! I'm gonna use a D-pad instead, but it works! I did it!
Get us out of here, Launchpad! Me number one dime returned safe and sound.
But Uncle Scrooge, well, what about the treasure?
Yeah, we had it and we lost it. Sorry, Uncle Scrooge.
Come on now, boys. We may not have got to keep the treasure, but we had the adventure of a lifetime. And best of all, we got to share it together. You, Webbergale, Launchpad.
And Epworth, too. Don't forget about Mrs. Beakley and Bubba. And Fenton and Shiro, they helped us too.
Indeed they did, lads. Now come on, let's head for home.
Let go of me, you doddering old deadweight!
Oh, pipe down, you mangy bird!
What happened to the enemies? Do I have to pay?
It was real swell of you to give Glamgold a lift home, Mr. McD.
I'll put it on your bill, Flinty. You can pay me back in, oh, say 3 to 5 years. With interest, of course.
I'll get you for this, McDuck. Mark my words.
Now, there's a sight I never get tired of. Come on, lads. Let's head to the ice cream shop.
Hey, can we each get our own cone this time, Uncle Scrooge?
So cheap!
Oh, why not? I'm in a generous mood today. In fact, each of you can even get a cone with ice cream in it.
Oh my! This guy's so cheap! Oh, here it goes. Listen.
Seems there.
This was beautiful. I hope you had fun. Look, listen to the sound. Is it beautiful? Is it less stressful? So what did we learn here today, kids? Well, we learned that greediness is bad. We can't let it get in the way of our families. You know, our children, our parents, or even our friends, or anyone. I know there's so much things talked about with money and success, but the real success is keeping the ones who you love. And also, getting me birdseed. I'm just throwing that in there. That's all I want to say. Well, maybe more. But all I want to say is, this is one of my favorite games. This was really good. Very challenging. I probably died like 3 times or something, but you know what? It was worth it. Some people today just want to go through a game without dying. You know? Not like Dark Souls or anything like that. I can't stand that game. But this is a balanced game. Real balance. I hope Capcom makes more of these. What do you want to see? Chip and Dale's Rescue Rangers? You want to see Darkwing Duck? Tailspin? Disney's Aladdin? Man, these were the golden years of Disney. What happened? It used to be so good! Beauty and the Beast? Little Mermaid? These were classics. Not just games, movies. The cartoons today, they need to be revived. Get a full schedule for these cartoons. I mean, some cartoons today are okay, but come on, they're nothing compared to this. They have lessons, values, they have feelings, creativity, real animation. It's beautiful. I hope today's kids could go back on a game like DuckTales. You know, DuckTales was a classic cartoon and also a classic game. They even had a movie. I think it's Something in the Lamp or something. I haven't seen it in a while, but I'm going to pick it up and watch it. You know, this game's a testimony of how great our time was back in the day. You know, I don't want to sound like I'm old or anything, because I'm a baby chicken. Chicken years are different than human years. You know? It's beautiful. You know, birds have a life too. I want everyone to stop eating us. Stop eating us. How do you feel like we just put you in the grill? Just ate you? You wouldn't like that. You know, look at my beautiful face. Look at me. Would you want to eat me? We're not tasty. We are not tasty. Just want to say that. Thank you for playing. Look at that. That's nice. You don't see that much today. I love it. And it goes right back to the screen. Oh, let me see if I put this here. That's beautiful. Alright. Well, everyone, I thank you for watching. Thank you for watching DuckTales. If you get any requests, let me know. I'll take in consideration. Alright? So please, keep up with Clocktown Television. Because we care, we're taking over the world. We want you to be alongside with us. Alright? So, keep tuning in on Clocktown Television on YouTube and here on Twitch TV. You can find me on Twitter, all right? Clocktown TV on Twitter, all right? So, okay, thanks again. Have a good day, and you'll see me again. Take care, everybody. I love you.